superheroes are an important symbol to us as Americans, but there's, I think they have specific significance to us here. We love their origin stories. Goes from being just like us and then changes. And in superhero situations, it's usually for the better. But it always involves something like trauma, like with Batman, bad start, leads you to go after justice for the rest of your life. You got some destiny. And usually with destiny, people want to avoid it. Jonah and the whale, Buffy the Vampire Slayer, we want to accept what's been handed to us. And sometimes it's just sheer chance that brings it. But I think that relates a lot to us here with cancer. All of us have faced trauma. We don't like our destiny, and we definitely don't like the sheer chance been dropped into our laps. I think that we like superheroes not because they show us how to be super, but because they show us how to be heroes. They inspire us, and they provide us with models of coping with adversity and finding meaning in the loss and trauma that we experience in our lives and discovering our strengths and using them for good purpose. And so I welcome you, superheroes. Yeah, let's celebrate.
Today we're here for Blue Lake Provides, and we're at the registration booth. My name is Isa, and your name?
Erin.
Erin, can you tell me what you all do at the registration booth?
We take pre-registered survivors and give them a t-shirt and a pen. And then we register any unregistered survivors so they can go to the dinner later on in the evening. This is my first year at the survivor booth, my third year volunteering here.
Well, thank you for your time. Hello, I'm here with
Tiffany Henry.
And who are you here with?
We're with the Phelps County Regional Medical Center.
How long have you been doing Relay for Life?
This is my first year doing Relay for Life.
What does Relay for Life mean to you?
Relay for Life means to me it's a nice way to honor survivors and families. You know, just a big event that they can come to for support and share their stories.
Thank you. Your name? What company are you sponsored Relay for Life?
We are with Mercy Clinic and Rolla.
And how many years have you been doing this?
I would say 9 years.
And have you been a survivor? Know someone that is a survivor?
My grandpa and my sister-in-law both are
cancer. What can I ask? What kind of cancer that's all right with
us? Lung cancer.
With two ladies, and can you state your name and what type of cancer and how long you have been a survivor?
My name is Debbie George. I had skin cancer. I've been in remission for 5 years.
My name is Laura Rossetti, and I've had it since 01, and it's thyroid cancer. And then I also, in 06, had uterine cancer.
Thank you, ladies, so much. Okay, I'm here with another cancer recipient. Can you tell me your name? And what type of cancer you have had?
My name is Shelley Morgan. I have breast cancer.
And how long have you been diagnosed with breast cancer, may I ask?
Diagnosed May 29th.
Of this year?
This year, and I have one more treatment left next week.
You're going through, are you only doing chemo?
Yes.
Are you going to do any type of radiation?
I'm not sure yet. I don't think so.
Well, thank you, and I will be praying for you. I'm here with another recipient of cancer. Can you tell me your name?
Genevieve Soil.
What type of cancer did you have?
Thyroid cancer.
And how long have you had it?
I was diagnosed November 2011.
And what kind of treatment have you been?
Radioactive iodine therapy, which is a radioactive pill.
I'm with a caregiver. Can you say your name and the people you have known that has had cancer?
My name's Beth Boyett, and my mom, Iva Doyle, had lymphoma, Hodgkin's cancer in 96. And then my sister, Genevieve Doyle, had thyroid cancer in 2011.
And how has it touched you, and do you know of anybody else that's had cancer?
My aunt Faye has had breast cancer. Just makes me aware that I need to get checked yearly for thyroid cancer and get checked regularly for other types of cancer.
Has anybody else in your family been touched besides your aunt, mom, and sister?
My grandfather died in 89 of what was known as the killer cancer.
Uncle Doug.
And my Uncle Doug had also the same type of cancer as my sister Genevieve, which was thyroid cancer. And what was so unique about it is they had surgery on the same day. And my uncle lives in Michigan.
Aunt Linda.
And my Aunt Linda also had cervical cancer in 2005.
Thank you.
Yep.
Hey, survivor. I was diagnosed back in 1998 with Hodgkin's lymphoma. And when I was diagnosed, I had two little ones at home, and I took the chemo treatment and the radiation. And now, due to the treatments I have, I was diagnosed with COPD because my lungs are scarred, and I have to wear oxygen when I'm walking and at night.
She dropped the phone and burst into tears. The doctor just confirmed her fears. Her husband held it in and held her tight. Cancer don't discriminate or care if you're just 38, with three kids who need you in their lives. He said, I know that you're afraid, and I am too, but you'll never be alone, I promise you. When you're weak, I'll be strong. Said they caught it just in time, but they had to take more than they planned. And now it's four smiles and baggy shirts to hide what the cancer took from her. And she just wants to feel like a woman again. She said, I don't think I can do this anymore. Took her in his arms and said, that's what my love is for. When you're weak, I'll be strong. When you let go, I'll hold on. And when you need to cry, I swear that I'll be there to dry your eyes. When you feel lost and scared to death, like you can't take one more. I'm gonna love you through.